So, no recollection of anything in the 24 hours prior to the accident, and patchy, I would say, 20 to 80% during the previous 8 weeks.
You know that I'm trying to get Matt to piece together what happened between him and me. You know that, and yet at this very crucial time there, you go filling his head with your complete bollocks.
I've just been in the bush there, having sex with an attractive young lady. I hope you're not upset or jealous at all.
No, not jealous.
Pregnancy can produce a number of conflicting emotions.
Act normal.
Septon, good morning.
Good mummy. Oh, Jesus!
Well, hello. You're in early. So are you.
Surprisingly
effective blowjob. Well, I'll be sure to pass that on.
Marvellous.
Excuse me, mate. He'll do full frontal nudity if you want.
Great. Yeah, only if there is no artistic justification and these two guys get to be my fluffers.
I don't get these documentary people.
They said they'd ring about what they wanted.
Oh, I forgot to say. I got a call yesterday from the producer thingy.
You did?
Yeah. Anyway, they've asked me to present something today, sort of, you know, token member of staff sort of thing.
What?
They said I looked like that person from Animal Hospital.
Rolf Harris?
No. Trudy. You know, the blonde, sexy one. Can't say myself, but they are the professionals.
I was supposed to do that. A special outfit and everything.
Oh, let's see. Where is it? Oh, that's nice.
So where's Guy? Mr. Bus?
Band.
Got a taxi then?
Band. Perhaps he's walking. Well, he's banned from walking.
It's not a bad idea, is it? Very well, some court taking away his driving license. Did they consider who they are letting loose on the pedestrian community?
What's a fluffer?
Come on, I'll show you.
Attention, everybody, please.
Okay, good morning, filmy people. A few ground rules, one or two do's and don'ts.
As some of you may already know, my name's Joanna Claw, and if I could just say before
I'm
you get
Sue
started...
I'm Sue White, and everything comes through me. That's not to say I've got bowel problems. A little bit of trap wind. Anyway, what it does mean is that I'm in charge of staff liaising and media.
What are you doing?
Laying down the law.
Yeah, you're not the sheriff in this town, I am.
Mm-hmm. Well, you can take your pointy star and shove it up your back crack. This is my area of expertise.
What, high-pitched squealing and scary eyes?
I do liaising and organising, which is your specialist field, being tall and menopausal.
Right, that's it. Get to your room. You're not to speak to the film crew for the rest of the day. Do you hear me? I arrange things in this hospital. I'm the lone arranger. I make the impossible possible.
Yeah, and you'd think it was impossible that Joanna here used to be a John. Check out the big clown feet. Huge. And the stubble.
Attention.
Dead giveaway. Get to your room. And she's still got a jobby jabber.
Get inside.
Go away.
I was thinking those bits of my memory that seem to have got mislaid, that you're probably wiped for good, but I'm very glad I'm catching up. It feels like you and I probably got on really well.
Sorry, do I know you?
Very good.
What's very good?
That bit when you pretend to be mean to me. Love that.
Who are you? What do you want?
Are you going to be like this all the time?
Look, I may have to call security.
Are you going to do this in theatre? You can't have too much of a good thing, you know.
Oh, ha-ha. I know what's happened here. You must be talking about my identical twin sister, Caroline.
Pardon? You're Caroline?
No. I'm actually Baroline.
Baroline?
Yes. You see, it was an alphabetical thing. I was born slightly earlier. Mm-hmm. And you are?
Dr. McCartney.
Dr. McCartney, pleased to meet you.
Yeah.
I hope we enjoy working together as much as my twin sister probably did.
Thanks very much.
See you later.
See you later.
Dr. Statham. All right, I'll be right with you. We can probably just pop those back on.
Right.
Shit. Sorry. Didn't you hear me honking? It's okay, I'm a doctor and you'll be fine. Look into my eyes. What's wrong with you? Come on!
Pulled out in front of me.
Sorry I'm late, the kids.
Took forever to get ready?
Oh, yeah, and then the traffic.
Terrible?
Yes, wasn't it? And then I had to stop off at... Oh. Well, who did I leave at the vet's then?
No pets allowed.
Here, look.
Just fly. It'll come back to you when you get up there. Come on, ready? You'll be fine. Here you go, OK? On count of three. 1, 2, 3.
My testosterone levels have been pushed up to an enormous 896.
Oh, well, that's quite high.
Yes, my body's become considerably hairier. I've had to move up a pant size, and I feel a lot more...
Oh, dear. Just lend yourself to him.
You see, I used to have an outlet, a highly charged, sexy sex colleague, but she's seen fit to turn her sexy back, as have I, it's reciprocal. Unfortunately, now my love cup rather runneth over. The juices have nowhere to dissipate. Mm.
Can you feel that?
No.
That?
No.
Oh, yeah. Call those backpacks. Get a real deal, you loser.
Slate 45, take one.
And action.
Angela, what are you doing?
I was filming a continuity shot.
No. That was dressage, was it? What's this?
Delusional woman finally losing her grip on reality?
No. What's this?
Cellulite.
It was a wiggle. You were walking with a wiggle.
Ah.
I've never seen you wiggle before.
Haven't you?
No, that's because you don't have a wiggle. You're just faking it for the camera.
I don't think so, Caroline. Besides, I'm not the one who has to invent quirky habits to get attention. And they all seem to like it.
Men like wiggly bottoms. Hold the front page. Angela, it's a documentary. It's supposed to show what we're really like.
Ah, well, why aren't you wearing your unflattering slacks and some sort of mismatched top, then?
Oh, you are.
Shall we take another shoot?
I want to report a murder threat.
Right. Who are you going to kill?
No, it's me. I might be killed.
Right.
I have got a videotape.
Really? Is it Thumbelina?
No, I gave that back. Guy has made a camcorder tape of him doing it with his, well, with our mother.
Squirrel.
No. Guy made a tape for a bet.
Did he? Right. Well, why did you give the tape to the king of the elf people?
But he thought I looked like a priest.
Well, were you in a pulpit?
No, I had a black T-shirt on with a white T-shirt underneath. Oh. I could kind of see that. And, you know, he was very, very drunk. And he wanted absolution, and I looked a bit priesty. And to be fair, I was hiding from Karen, and so I had a false beard and some glasses. But even though he thought I was a priest, he threatened to kill me if I told anyone.
Just as well you haven't told me then, isn't it?
No.
Welcome to our humble palace of miracles. But I should point out that at committee level, I could have poo-pooed your plan to disrupt medical science for the sake of televisual titillation, but luckily I gave you the benefit of any dubiety. So you stick with me and everything should run like the proverbial baby's bottom. Smoothly.
And you are?
Dr. Alan Statham. Consultant radiologist. That's,
oh dear,
it's a bit rude. Should actually say cunt. Consultant. But I've ordered a new one.
Right.
Well, I just thought, you know, murder threat. Tell someone. It's... Okay, right. Just, I've not been in here. Okay, I've not told you anything. We'll leave it at that. Yeah. Okay.
Now slow down, Shorty.
Well, it's not in my pants.
No!
I can't give that to you. Don't do anything bad with it.
No.
I also would like to say that I dabble in humorous writing.
Oh,
yes. No, there it is. Should you require any addenda to your scripts with an informed medical slant, yet at the same time having a slightly sardonic or satirical...
Addenda?
Excuse me?
Addenda?
Yes, plural of addendum.
Addendum, yes, yes. Would your contributions be in English or Latin?
Could be either, clearly.
I think early Aramaic might be best.
That's maybe. Just...
They've gone.
That's...
All right. Vale! Vale te!
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yes. I'm joking.
Yeah, and that was when he said that I was crap in bed. I was fucking devastated. But it turned out that what he was actually trying to say was that I'd crapped in the bed. I had been very pissed that night, so that was okay. Sue White wants you to go to her office.
What?
Sue White wants you to go...
Yes, I heard. If she calls again, tell the caber-tossing tart I have rang. She comes to my office.
She said you'd say that. She said to say she's got something sitting on her desk. She made me write it down. Something to do with your son putting his undersized sausage in your catering-sized oven and it getting burnt and it all being hilariously caught on camera.
Yeah.
And she wants to show it to you as she's thinking of sending it to you who've been framed. So that's good, isn't it? Because you get £250 for every clip they show. A bit overexcited because her cookery clip might be shown on You've Been Framed.
I'm just saying it's a male dominated workplace.
Bollocks!
I've got a few other points you could prove for me if you like.
It's not male dominated, there are bloody women everywhere.
Crunching underfoot everywhere you walk.
Yeah, have you ever paid for a woman to walk on you? I have. It's pointless, really hurt.
Wow, it's like working with Jermaine Greer.
She was alright in her time, a bit tall.
Big mouth.
Yeah, well, not a hindrance. Not a hindrance at all. Because, you see, I've got a great big cock.
Guy, shush.
And massive testes.
Dr. Todd, little fiddly bit coming up now. So if we can just...
They're like cricket balls. They're like sort of, well, tennis balls, actually. Well, no, boule. They're like boule. Boule batonque. You know, huge, throbbing nutsacks. Massive, quivering gonads. What are you staring at, Mr. Average Ginger Bollocks? Like, they're like two tiny Scotch eggs, and you've got no balls at all.
You're right, I'm a great big freak.
Like that, soft.
You insane Caledonian bitch. I want to tear your face off and eat it. Please, please give me the tape back. I will give you money. What do you want?
Put them in.
Bugger off.
I desire you to put them in. Let's play find the lady accidentally having sex with her son. Ready?
Want.
Couple of things.
Yes.
You to know your place.
Yes, and?
I want to fly like a bird, like a plane.
Well, it's impossible.
Oh, now, come on, eh? You, the lone arranger, the one that makes the impossible possible.
It was a figure of speech.
Like a tiny bird woman, I want to glide in the air. Now leave me. I must rest my skitty eyes. The teeth! They were my grandmother's. She used to lick the dog's balls with them. Ah! It's just such a rush. Whiz! It's a real surge of whoosh. A little bit, da-da, and also a bit, one more minute and those babies might not have made it. It's making those split-second decisions and getting it right that makes my job so satisfying.
Cut.
Yes.
Wow.
You are brilliant.
Thanks. To be honest, I am feeling a bit horny.
Blood makes you horny.
No, putting my hand up women.
Oh.
And delivering babies, it's amazing.
Right.
Want to see some action in the delivery room?
Please.
Let me lead you in.
I knew she could act, but I didn't know Angela could do slut.
Yeah, talking of doing sluts, I went down on a guide leader the other night. She gave me a special badge.
And we're back.
What's that then?
Badge.
Badge.
Advanced copy knotting.
No, no, you naughty, no, you may not smack my bare bottom, you, it, absolutely, oh dear, you've caught us, we thought you were away, and while the cat's away, we thought we mice would have a bit of a play.
You're not in the mood, Alan, possibly the worst day of my life.
Oh dear, oh. Kim, isn't it?
Yeah.
Kim. Tell you what, if you and I were related, you would be my Kith and Kim.
Mm.
Yes, it is. I don't suppose they'd let us have a Kith with...
You trying to be funny?
Yes, well, careful, because when the rapier of my wit is fully unsheathed, you know, I can make a woman laugh until she fills her shoes with piddle.
You don't say.
Yes, yes, same. That's, so... No, I got it. I got it. There it is. It's fine.
Can I help you?
Well, no, just, you know, nothing. Just, enjoying the you, the view, view of you, not, the...
Do you want a closer look?
Well, yeah, yes, I do. Yes, I do. Oh, dear. I think we're probably married now. I just said, I do.
Well, seeing as we're married, perhaps we should have a kiss. Do you think?
Kiss me so she sees.
OK. Are you ready?
Oh, my God.
Close your eyes.
Wait. Joanna, look, we're doing kissing. No, one second. No, don't. Where?
What's going on here?
She's...
Dr. Statham tried to have me on my desk. Is this true, Ellen?
No, she stapled me.
Did you try to have her on this desk?
No, why would I have her on the... Why, try? No. All right.
Get out, Ellen. Come on. Don't come back or I'll prosecute.
Don't. Plenty more ties like this.
Yes, what do you want, freak?
I was just about to watch a really hot video.
Oh, look, I haven't got time for games.
Funny. You did when you filmed this. Monsieur, you must be more careful with your camcorder tapes. Not exactly a pair of lookers, are you?
How did you get hold of that tape?
How do you solve a problem like Marie?
No, listen to me, okay? If anyone else sees that tape, I'll kill you.
Oh, really?
I'll shoot your pointy face off.
I think that's highly unlikely. I could, however, be persuaded to postpone distribution.
Well, what do you want?
Two things. Firstly, secret of fire.
And?
Let's keep the trod from entangling herself once more in the lion's mane, shall we? Set the lion free. Free!
Right. You want me to get an actual lion?
No, I want you to keep Dr. McCartney away from Dr. Caroline.
I know! I'm playing your game. It's such an easy game to play. Oh, look at me! I'm mad and I'm scorch!
We weren't there then.
Yeah. Deep fry yourself. Half Swiss beats mad scotch any day of the week.
Right, listen to me. Do anything. Marry her if you have to.
Actually, I was thinking of marrying her at some point.
Dream on. Just keep them apart, would you? Or this. Starts doing the perv circuit.
Oh, shitting Jesus.
Just do it. I must rest. Do my bidding.
Take that back, Mr. Boyce.
No.
Yes, I insist that you take it back.
No.
Take it back, please.
No.
Yes, take it back.
No.
You 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 take it back.
No.
Take it back, 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 take it
back. All right. You're not a pedant.
Properly.
I'm sorry. You're not a pedant.
Bloody. You said bloody.
You're not a bloody pedant.
Good. Thank you. Now then, where were we?
Well, 10 minutes ago, it was 1 minute past 12, and I made the heinous error of saying good morning. The rest is history.
Yes, well, Mr. Boyce, where would history be without its great sticklers for detail? I mean, would Louis Pasteur, do you think, have said good morning if it was clearly the afternoon?
Well, I think Louis Pasteur would probably have said bonjour.
No, forgive me, he would have said, if it was a minute past midday, bon après-midi.
I don't think Louis Pasteur would have said anything to you, let alone giving you the time of day.
That is disrespectful. You take that back now.
No.
Yes, you take it back.
No.
All right, I've got all day. All right, everybody leave, go on! Not you, Mr. Boyce! You stay here until you take it back.
I'm not going to take it back.
I'm glad you have learnt your lesson. I've got things to do. Stop, where are you going?
Well, you said I had to stick with you until I take it back.
Well, yeah, I didn't mean you had to follow me around everywhere.
So, take it back.
All right! All right, I take it back, but now do you take it back?
No.
All right, in that case, I take back my take back.
So, does that mean I do have to stay with you?
No. No.
So take it back.
No, I won't.
Oh, dear, shall we open up another one of those, thingamajigs?
Wait, I know this one. Is it, body? Body.
Body. Body. Body.
Yeah, well, I think we'll soon have one of those through here.
Good.
In the,
cinema?
Theatre.
Theatre. Right. No.
What? Oh, it's just a bit weird.
What?
What? The, what? Oh, just seeing you be nice to her, you know. You know, the sarcastic witch. Your words, not mine. You probably won't remember.
No, I would never say anything like that about anyone.
Well, you, not normally you wouldn't, know, but, you really hated her.
Why would I hate her?
I don't know, it beats me, actually, because I've really gone well with her, but she did... Well, actually, she did used to criticise you a lot. She, all the time, actually, she used to call you clumsy in theatre, you were arrogant, emotionally sterile.
No, I'm not clumsy in theatre, that's ridiculous.
No, you're not, no, you're not, that's the whole point, you're not. She'd call you arrogant and emotionally sterile in social situations. She said you were a bike-obsessed, fop-haired git, which is...
Really? Really?
Yeah. It's all right, though. I mean, it's no...
No.
No big deal, is it?
We all have to work together.
You'll be fine.
She seems civil enough now.
Yeah. Yeah, doesn't she? Doesn't she? I mean, that's because she's putting on a really good front. It's probably because you've been unwell, but that was what was making me laugh, you know. Yeah. Anyway, yeah. All right.
That was nice. Gentle, but firm.
Yeah, what I wanted to say was...
Yeah?
why don't me and you have an open relationship?
You mean see other people?
Yeah?
I don't want to see other people. Do you want to see other people?
Me? I've not really thought about it, to be honest, but, yeah, if you want, I mean...
How often would we see each other?
I don't know, maybe once every year?
What?
Well, 10 months, then. Once every 10 months. I mean, it's just, it's fluid, you know, that's the point. So what do you think?
I'm going to say no.
Yeah, but it could be once every 2 days. It would depend on circumstances. Yeah, I mean, I'll think about it and get back to me. I love you.
Right, I've decided. You can leave. You don't have to take it back.
No, I'm not leaving until I take it back.
No, everything's back, and I hereby release you from all future take-backs.
No, well, it's not, and you can't.
It is, and I can, and you can't be in here.
I can, and I will.
You shan't.
Could.
You wouldn't.
I would.
You wouldn't.
I would.
You wouldn't.
I hod.
You hodn't.
I nod.
You nodn't.
I cough.
You couldn't.
I did do.
You didn't do.
I do.
You didn't. Now, look away, I'm...
You peed.
I peedn't.
You ped.
I pedn't.
You pedn't.
No, I... You pedn't.
No.
Yes.
No, take it back.
No, you take it back.
No, take it back.
No, you take it back.
Take it back.
No, don't you. I mean, no.
Hey.
Hi.
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 Hi. This is difficult, actually.
Really?
Yeah. I just wanted to say that I know that there was maybe something going on between us before the accident.
You know?
Yeah. Well, I know that I behaved in a certain way and you behaved in a certain way, and I think that maybe there was, like a misunderstanding.
A misunderstanding?
Yeah, maybe we got our wires crossed and... I'm sorry. It was probably my... Well, it was definitely my fault. Basically, what I'm saying is it shouldn't have happened.
Are you sure?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. I thought maybe we could start again and, with a clean slate, put all that shit behind us. What do you think?
You say so.
Any few thoughts?
from the Navy.
Ow!
What the hell were you thinking of? Making a bloody tape.
Yeah, all right, good point, but I needed proof for a bet.
Bet? But you had a bet.
Let me finish. For a better way of improving my technique. I do it with my golf swing as well. I video that. You check the stance and the grip and the position of the shaft on impact. See where you're going wrong.
I'm sicker than I thought.
Yeah.
And how did that evil Scottish harpy get her talons on it?
Yeah, well, frankly, this is the disgusting bit. I gave it to a priest and the bastard seems to have fucked me over.
You gave it to a priest?
Yeah, well, I was pissed at the time and confessing seemed like a good idea. You don't expect to get shat on by the clergy, do you?
This is a nightmare.
Yeah.
I'm going to be a gimp for the rest of eternity.
Trouble making her look real.
What is she doing working in a hospital?
Working? No, I don't think so. Not since you've been here.
Wasted.
What?
She is completely wasted.
Yeah, I'm really sorry. I think she had a couple of large vodkas this morning.
I mean, she just ticks every box. Face, yes. Voice, yes. Body, yes.
Yes, it's almost unheard of, isn't it, having all three?
Hello.
Hey.
Guess what? Patrick's going to Toronto.
Bye!
No, next week. Yeah, he's making a part-improvised doc rom-com and he wants me to go with him, the madman.
It is not mad. It is about the sanest thing I've ever done in my life.
That is very worrying. Do they let you drive?
I mean, the crystals are just kind of aligning for me right now. I mean, we're almost there with the funding and now this angel has just fallen into my lap. You know, sometimes you just get a gut reaction.
Yeah, I'm getting quite a strong one of those as we speak.
Toronto sounds so exciting. Just part of me thinks I should just bloody go.
Well, you can't miss out on a doc rom-com-pom-pom.
No pom-poms.
Are you sure? Maybe you play a cheerleader.
That's a good idea.
Or a poncho.
She's sworn us to secrecy, but I've got to tell you, you know, you and Caroline.
Yep.
Before the accident, you know.
What, we took cocaine together?
No. Big buddies, yeah? Yeah.
I mean, say
no
more.
Yeah.
Interesting that I just heard a slightly different story from Guy.
Yeah, but who'd you trust more, me or Guy?
It's a tricky one.
Well, I'd swear on my penis.
Then I would be forced to believe you. Plus, of course, if I ask you, who would you trust more, Guy or anyone else in the world, it's not really Guy, is it?
Yeah, you see, I don't even really need the penis thing, did I?
Not really. See ya.
Oh, here we go. Coming up to the big 500. 490, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Whoa! Oh, no, you dropped the rope. Shit.
What did you do that for? You ruined it.
Sorry. You know what I've done, don't you? I have thrown a spanner in the works. Why would anyone want to do that? Shit. Better go and ask my old friend Caroline Todd, because apparently we used to get on really well.
Yeah, I can explain about that.
Leave it. This is ridiculous, isn't it? It's pathetic. You find something that you can't have, so you have to destroy it.
That isn't it.
Save it. I understand that jealousy does terrible things.
Fuck off, it's not jealousy.
Yeah, what was it then?
Well, it...
What was it?
I can't say.
Oh, finally run out of excuses.
No, all right. I was blackmailed into it.
Brilliant. There's one left, right down at the bottom of the dirty, mucky little barrel. Blackmail? Yeah, love it.
Brilliant.
I was!
Kim,
Get me Sue White's file and look for dirt. Anything. Arson, abuse, pilfering, embezzlement. Yep.
And I want a chandelier.
A chandelier?
A motorised one.
Oh, don't be I'll see what I can do.
I shall drive it through the hospital, waving at people.
Are you sure you mean a chandelier?
Harp, parp. Wave.
Right, what have we got? Anything?
Oh, wait, there's a complaints file.
I knew it.
Pop,
pop, pop.
Wait, 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 wait.
Pop, 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 honk, honk. Pop.
What's that?
A card.
Oh, what's the occasion?
Nothing. No, just me getting out of the lift, I suppose.
So can I have it now?
No, not yet, not yet. No, because I'll give it to you, now. No, don't open it yet. Hello, can I get some help, please? We're stuck in the lift. Please, quickly.
Can I have the card?
No, not yet.
No, go on.
No, I think it's probably best you open it later.
No,
because you'll spoil it.
Give me the card.
There you go.
Oh, sad little puppy face. So sorry you're leaving. Sorry I'm leaving.
Oh, my stomach. Ah.
Dear Karen, I do really like you, but I think we should stop seeing each other.
Oh, my God, I've got cancer. That's what it is.
Completely. No offence, you're sorrowfully Martin.
Kiss. That is bizarre. Do you know what?
What?
Somebody has tip-exed out my original message, OK, and written their own message in there, forged my writing. What? I mean, why would somebody do that? That's just evil. That's probably Guy. Just... What's that?
All right?
Fine. You?
Yeah, good. I wanted to say to you, please ignore what I said earlier about us wiping the slate clean, because apparently it was never dirty.
Wasn't it?
No. No, sadly, a rogue anaesthetist persuaded me that we were sworn enemies in a previous life. I now believe that to be a fabrication.
Oh, it is. It is, yeah, complete fabrication.
Good. That's good.
You've got the weirdest foreplay of any woman I know.
I have got a bone to pick with you, Dr. Secretan.
I don't do surgery, I just knock them out.
About you lying to Mac.
Me? Lie? Oh, it's his funny brain, isn't it? He's probably forgotten what I said.
He remembers what you said, Guy.
Well, maybe you forgot what he said.
No, no, I have an excellent memory.
Well, they're both quite good.
What?
Oh, memory. Sorry, I thought you said mammary.
Excellent memory.
Gotcha. Yeah, yeah. You're like an elephant.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, you're really winning me round now.
Not in a bad way. You're not sort of big and fat and grey.
No, that's actually not big and fat and grey.
Oh, hello.
Cocky. She's like lowering her standards.
Marvo the memory man. Funny, we were just talking about elephants. Mm-hmm. And have you seen the size of his ears? Look at that. That's why he has the long, girly hair.
Yeah, but you're the one with a great big long nose that you can't help sticking into other people's business, aren't you? You with your big donkey face and your great long trunk and your one hairy caterpillar eyebrow.
All right, all right. Do I go around saying you look like a Harrier jump jet?
I don't know, do you?
Don't know, do I?
Mm. Memory like a sieve, this one.
Yeah, it's the drink, that's what does it.
I can handle my drink.
Can you?
Oh, yes, this from a man who thought Martin was a priest. Excuse me. You mistook Martin for a priest.
Excuse me.
Okay, you staggered up to me, you went, oh, this met a really nice priest. You pointed at Martin, you fell over.
Excuse me.
Dr. Angela Hunter. Hunter by name, Angela by nature.
I have a hypothetical question.
I have a hole punch. So let's not get big-headed.
What would happen if a paediatric registrar were to resign?
Well, he, she, or indeed it, would have to serve a minimum 8 weeks' notice unless otherwise stated in their contract.
Hmm. Any way of bringing that time down a bit?
To how long?
Just over 3 hours.
Do I look like a mug? Have I got a handle? Am I made of china? Am I kept in a cupboard or in a small wooden tree? Hmm? Would you like to put your lips on my rim? You may answer that question. The others were rhetorical.
This is a chance of a lifetime. If it doesn't happen now, it may never happen.
Are we still on the rim thing?
No! My career change! So are you going to be able to help me, or should I go straight to Joanna?
Well, I think you'll find Joanna is currently my bitch. I am top dog, so to speak, but as it happens, I may be able to facilitate an early release.
Really?
Yes. But I would, however, have to ask you to inform Dr. McCartney of Dr. Todd's tragic hereditary disease.
Oh, well, you know me. There are certain times when I have absolutely no scruples whatsoever.
I can't believe you're just letting her...
Can't go, just like that.
Alas, she has gone to a better place.
It's Telly. She hasn't died.
Not died.
I know you're busy. We're all busy, and arguably I am busier than any. In fact, I would go so far as to say that, comparatively, on the scale of busyness importance, consultant... Hmm? Director, nevertheless, despite my busyness, I have managed to pen for you a rather amusing medical ditty as follows. A's for appendectomy, B's
no.
for barium. I knew it. Right, bird songs of Northern Europe. The corncrake.
Go away.
Yep, it's a terrible thing.
If I find out who told Sue White about that tape...
Yeah, I know, it's a mystery. We should sleep on it, I just think.
Two people knew about it. Me, the priest. I'm the victim, so that rules me out.
Ah, yes, but does it?
Yes, it does.
Well, no, because on Miss Marple you wouldn't be ruled out. On Miss Marple it's always the one you least suspect.
Forget Miss Marple.
No, because she is a very talented detective.
She looks like a scrotum in a hat.
There are many strings to my bow. The final string I'm going to offer you is this. Shadow puppetry. Wolf. See? Very effective with the light and everyone. All right, what's this? What's this?
It's your hand.
Bloody ignorant Irish ponce! Fuck off!
I think he's gone.
Would that you had were.
No, I think we need to concentrate on finding the identity of the priest.
Oh, no, forget the priest. The priest is going to be gone out of the country.
Not necessarily. And I'd remember that face anywhere.
Really?
Yeah. What was his name now? Father Martin O'Dear.
Oh, dear.
Oh, dear.
So you think I'm the priest? You think I'd just betray you?
I'm sorry it's come to this, Martin. We're friends and we're family. I wish things could have been different.
Oh, they could.
No, they can't. This hurts me.
It's gonna hurt me too, isn't it?
Yeah.
Bye. You little scum,
beach. Go on, swimmer.
Hello? It's my passport ready.
Sign Angela's leaving card?
Oh, do I have to?
Well, I think you're the only one who hasn't, so she'll probably notice if you don't.
I haven't got time.
It's only going to take a minute.
No, it'll take at least half an hour. It always does.
Yeah? Why?
Because I have to write the wittiest thing on the whole card, OK?
I see. Too late. I've already done that.
Oh, you have. Well, that's not fair. You can't get wittier than that.
I know.
Oh, can I put that too?
I'm not sure it really works if you put the same thing twice.
Damn you. I could tip X out Mac and put Caroline.
Could do, then I would have to think of something else.
Don't care.
Okay, how about putting an arrow that says, I told Mac to say this because he couldn't think of anything better.
I love you.
I love you too.
I love you for helping me with that really, really
yeah,
good
no,
suggestion.
Yeah, I know what you meant, yeah.
Good, good.
Hey, Mac.
Okay, that is the worst going to the toilet I've ever seen.
Yeah, a guy said that he was going to phone the gays.
Which gays?
Well, all of them.
The thing you have to understand about the gays is that they're probably a lot more scared of you than you are of them.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, cheers, Mac. Yeah, that does make me feel slightly better.
Should I cut you down?
Yeah, if you could, please. Yeah, then I can get that tape back off Sue White.
What tape?
The tape that... Oh, shit. Done it again.
Got a rubbish vagina.
And your cock is as thin and pointy as a pencil. Bye, doggy dick. Oh, Dr. McCartney, now this is a late visit.
Yeah, yeah. It's about a tape.
And a bear.
No, a tape.
Yeah, I know. I've just always wanted to say that.
Sue White, I need the tape of Guy and Joanna.
No. Oh, Dr. McCartney, there are so many things I would give you, though.
Yeah, should we start with the tape?
But why, oh, why?
Because I'm going to give it back to them and they're going to destroy it.
But...
You can do this, Sue. You can do this. Just show me. Show me. Show me that you have a heart.
Oh, I admire your pallor.
My opinion regarding your nether regions still obtains.
You have magical powers, you do.
Yes.
You are a,
Yes.
A queen.
Yes.
A queen, a crazy. Crazy with power, but yes. You have a heart. Set them free. Set them free.
It's in my pants.
I want what's in your pants.
Someone. I'm going to let him buy me a drink.
You can't do that.
Yes, I can. You dumped me. I can do what I like.
Yeah, but I didn't realise other people would be interested.
Came as a bit of a shock to me, actually.
Well, you're undumped.
Oh, that's romantic. Aren't you going to say something to him?
Yes. Excuse me.
Meal C for two for one, please.
For once?
Yes, for one, just me, all alone, nobody else. Obviously, if she were here, she'd probably have pork balls, but oh dear, no, not anymore. She'd probably rather be having dirty sex with her own son again.
Hi. So, Caroline, this is it. Fond farewell.
Yep, well, I'm happy for you.
Are you? Gosh, how mature of you. I thought you'd be seething with jealousy. But no, thanks. We must finally be true friends. You must really like me.
No, you're right. I hate your success. I hate your wiggle and I hate your flicky hair.
No, you're just saying that.
No, I mean it.
I know. You're the perfect girlfriend.
Take it easy.
Oh, God, it already feels a bit weird now she's gone, doesn't it? I feel very emotional. I feel a bit sad. I just want a hug.
No.
No? Give us a hug. Give us a hug, please.
No.
Hug? No?
Oh, tired. Very tired. Been in front of the camera all day. Yeah,
right.
It's been filming. Probably, yes. Yeah, we've wrapped. Yeah. I have to say, the director, a bit of a tit, a bit of an oafish Irish bog person, had a song prepared and he wasn't prepared. He wasn't prepared. Oh, no, we haven't got time for the song. Beg pardon. What is the song, you ask?
Actually, I think your food's almost ready.
A is for appendectomy, B is for barium, C is for cystitis, defibrillates for D, that's how it goes. E is for echocardiography, that's quite complex, isn't it? F's a fucking director. G is for gobshite, and he is a bastard, is H, and I is bloody pissed off. J is for jiggly jugs, and K is for kicking ass, and lady lips is L, and M is penis is for P, and Q is for queer. No, I'm not queer, not me, you know. R is for rectum, and S is for shits and slits, and tiny tits is T, and U is a bastard, and V is for vagina, and V, W is for wanky wank, and Y fronts is for Y, and X-ray is for Z, and no person it knows. A is an asshole, B is a bastard, C is for... Oh, cock off!
Go away. Shoo. Stop. Just hold.
That should not have been erotic.
Two more minutes.